What's going on, guys? I'm With The Moose, and today I'm back on MLB 17, the show Diamond Dynasty, and they dropped a bombshell today of a blog. Usually these come out on Friday. I don't know if this is the new normal. You know, they're going to release stuff on Wednesday. I honestly do not know. I think they did it because June is tomorrow, or it starts tomorrow. Of course, today being May 31st, so I'm assuming that's why, and they wanted to get this out for June, but we'll see. Either way, I'll obviously keep you guys updated, regardless of what day they drop some new information. So this is actually pretty interesting. The first thing up is, and of course, link to the blog down below if you guys want to read through it in its entirety, but there's new 12-0 rewards dropping in the game right now for Battle Royale. Of course, that would be a 97 Eric Gagne and a 96 Joey Votto. Unfortunately, I don't think those guys are going to be up on the market right now. Actually, they can't even be on the market. Oh, wait, yeah, they can. What the hell am I saying? But I'm looking and I do not see the Gagne here. And unfortunately, you know, I doubt that anyone has gotten the Joey Votto either. Yeah, looks like no Joey Votto up. So those are two of the better players in the entire game. A 97 overall Eric Gagne, a breakout edition of him when he kind of burst onto the scene. I would have to imagine they're going to be a 99 overall Gagne for when he won the Cy Young and had that insane save streak of like 70 plus games. I think that was somewhere around like 06, 07. I can't remember exactly, but somewhere in that range. And then also the Joey Votto should be really cool. So cool cards, definitely excited about it. Unfortunately, I'm definitely not good enough to get a 12-0 in Battle Royale, but I guess you never know. And if you guys are, then hey, take advantage of that and enjoy. Now, next thing up is actually a new program, which is awesome. We'll take a look at that in a little bit. And then finally, there are new packs in the game. Set 5 packs finally here. And there's two great rewards that you can get, or two of the, you know, highlight players or whatever in this one are both Impact Veterans, because of course the new program is an Impact Veteran, so it kind of aligns with that. And the new sets have a 94 overall Nolan Ryan and a 97 overall CC Sabathia. So let's take a look real quick. Let's find that Nolan Ryan real fast and see what he looks like. He's right there going for around 146,000 and 80,000 to sell now. You guys can see his stats there in the bottom right. 99 break, 84 velocity, 95 hit per 9, 99 K per 9, also 94 stamina. Let's check the pitches that he has. A 4-seam, circle change, a curveball, and a 2-seam fastball. This is actually a little bit different than his card you get for the Angels reward. The Angels one has a 4-seamer, a regular changeup. Although regular changeup versus circle change, not too much of a difference. He has the curveball and he also has a running fastball, which is, you know, kind of similar to a two-seamer, but a little bit different. So I'll be interested to see how this card kind of compares. It does have lower velocity, but the other one I think has lower, you know, per nines and stuff. So it'll be interesting to see which one's better. This one is a better overall, so you'd anticipate that it would be better, but who knows? We'll have to wait and see. Either way, they're both great cards. Next up is obviously that CC Sabathia. This is an Impact Veteran from the year that he got traded to the Brewers, and he went on an incredible run. One of my favorite, you know, times in baseball, honestly, was just watching him pitch. If you guys don't remember, or you know, weren't old enough to remember anything like that, he got traded to the Brewers around the trade deadline, maybe a little bit earlier, and essentially pitched every third day for like 2 months straight to get him into the playoffs. Incredible run. He was pitching complete games left and right. I think he had like 8 complete games that season. He had an incredible season, or incredible like 2 months, honestly, on top of, you know, a good season overall. And I would love to have this card, although it's very expensive. You guys can see the stats here. He's got a 4-seam slider, changeup, and curveball, very similar to his other card, the one that everyone has from Conquest, which I think adds a sinker. Other than that, though, it's basically the same card. Cool card, but like I said, too expensive for me at least, but it is a nice addition to the game, and I'm very excited that it's in there, because like I said, it's one of my favorite times in baseball. Now, let's take a look at the new program. Like I mentioned, real quick, who is it going to be? Roy Oswalt, you guys can see it right there. Impact Veteran program, the first Impact Veteran. If we scroll all the way over, you guys can see the reward is a 93 overall Roy Oswalt. You know, same deal with all the other programs. You get some program packs, some XP. You do get a Phillies flashback at 50%. Not sure who that's going to be yet. And finally, of course, the 93 overall Roy Oswalt, which is pretty cool. Unfortunately, can't show you his stats. They didn't tweet it or anything like that, at least as far as I saw, but I'm sure he's pretty good. Actually, they did show it. What am I saying right here? It's in the blog. I feel like I'm nuts right now. They did show his stats right here. I'll pop it up on screen for you guys. 91 stamina, 94 K per 9, 94 hit per 9, 69 K per 9. The velocity 79, break 79. So it looks like a decent card, you know, not too bad, not too great per se. Cool card though. I definitely will use it once I get it, because it's kind of fun to mess around with new guys. He has a 4-seamer, a changeup, sinker, 12-6 curve, and a slider. So a really nice pitch selection there. You know, a good mix of speed with the fastball and the sinker, and also, you know, off speed with that changeup, curveball, and slider. So I really do like that card. definitely, you know, an option once I get that one, and it's going to be exciting. Now, how do you get it? If we flip over, press R1, you guys can see here are all the missions that you need to do. We'll just go right into them, though. If you click X, you can go right into them. And right here, this is going to be the toughest one for sure. So this one is Match Royals wants 2010 statistics with Impact Veteran Series starting pitchers in Diamond Dynasty games. Now, that does mean you can get this in, you know, Play versus CPU, in Conquest, things like that. But you need 211 innings pitch, which is actually a ridiculous amount. Wow. 13 wins, 193 strikeouts, and 2 complete game shutouts. A couple of those not too bad. The wins and the complete game shutouts you can do in Conquest, like I said. Just knock those out. They're very, very easy to do. But the innings pitch and the Ks are just going to take time. You just got to devote the effort. But like I said, you can do it, you know, against the computer. So, you know, get it on rookie, and honestly, it won't be too tough. Next one up, and I'm looking at these for the first time, so we'll see if I, you know, if I can analyze these correctly. Let's see, deadline one game for this one, you have to tally at least 8 strikeouts and get the win with a Philadelphia Phillies starting pitcher in the same game. I'm trying to think of the starting pitchers off the top of my head. Jeremy Hellickson, honestly, I don't really know anyone else besides him. I'm sure there's somebody maybe better than him, but I'm not entirely sure. Maybe there's a good, you know, flashback that I'm not thinking of, but that isn't really that tough, it doesn't seem, because like I said, you can also do this in a Play versus CPU game. Obviously, you'd have to be that likely to get the 8 strikeouts. It would be kind of tough to do that in a Conquest game. Now, next one up is also one game deadline. You have to pitch a complete game shutout and get the win and tally at least 6 strikeouts with an Impact Veteran Series starting pitcher in the same game. So that's not too bad. Also, same deal, play it in a Play versus CPU. Get a complete game shutout, get a win, and get 6 strikeouts. You actually could possibly do this in a Conquest game, so keep it in mind. You just need 6 strikeouts, which might be a little bit tough. Next one up is actually the Oswalt trade, which I heard a little bit about. This one, you need to exchange these 3 players, Jonathan VR, J.A. Happ, and Anthony Ghost. So it's definitely something interesting to do. Actually, you just have to collect them, so you still get to keep them. Let's see if I have all of them. I knew I had VR, but unfortunately, I don't have Happ or Ghost. Let's see what they're all going for. I know VR is going for a lot, over 10K right now. He's not even good at all, but somebody keep in mind, J.A. Happ probably going up in price as well. Not too bad. And Anthony Ghost, I know, was going up a lot. Looks like, yeah, 1,400. That sucks. I definitely just quick sold him, you know, a couple days ago because I was going through my free agent. So that's just kind of, you know, needlessly expensive. But be aware, it's the first day. Just wait it out if you plan on doing this program. Next one up is exchange Philadelphia Phillies player items. Let's see how many points you need. 30,000, so that's, I mean, it's not too bad. Let's say if we did Aaron Nola, Michael Franco, and Ikoff, that's already 8,200. I mean, it's really not that bad. That's really, you know, not a huge concern, I would say. And final one is going to be collect 3 pitchers who have a hit per 9 attribute of 80 or above. So let's just see what the options are here. We got like Dan Straley, you know, Chris Archer, Liriano, actually some pretty good pitchers in here. So it might be a little difficult to do this, but honestly, it's not going to be that bad because you only collect them. So a guy like Dan Straley, I don't care about. Chris Archer, I can't sell anyway, so I don't mind collecting him. Liriano, I could sell, so I kind of mind collecting him. But Garza, I don't. So, you know, guys like that, I can collect them no problem and don't really have to worry about it too much. So honestly, I don't think this is that tough. You don't have to, at least as far as I'm seeing, you do not need to play online whatsoever for this. And I'm very surprised with that, to be honest. I thought you would have had to play online all the other programs you were required to. In some shape or form. So I'm kind of excited about it. I can just grind some, you know, versus CPU and some, you know, Conquest and whatnot and get that Royal Swat soon. So that's pretty interesting. But finally, let's get into some packs. We got to open them up, go to packs. Let's buy some. Let's just get a 10 bundle because obviously I don't have almost any stubs right now. Been working on a ton of different things and definitely don't have a lot of stubs to be, you know, cracking open a huge bundle. Do have a program pack. Don't care about it though. Let's get these set 5s and see what we get. Got an Ender Inciarte as our topper. Not too bad, but let's keep it rolling. 10 packs to go, looking for that Nolan Ryan or CC Sabathia. Can we do just that? Looks like not in this one. So let's keep it rolling though. 9 to go. I actually did get a Sam Travis in that last one, which is not too bad. He's one of the better, you know, newer cards to pull, I guess, because he's on the Red Sox and also is a new card. So any new cards that pop in the game, new players that get called up from the minor league that make their debut or whatnot, generally going to sell for a little bit more. Did get a silver here. Eric Thames. All right, we'll take it. Honestly, I don't know what he's doing lately. I assume he's still hitting well, but honestly, I haven't heard his name really at all. You know, I don't watch Brewers games or anything like that unless the Sox are playing him. So, you know, I don't know. If you're a Brewers fan, let me know how Thames is doing in the comments down below. Did get a gold cleat there. That's all right, I guess. Anything else? Not quite. Josh Edgen going to be our final card there. Next pack up, what are we going to get? A bunch of garbage again. Still nothing. These packs are awful right now. I don't know what we're doing here. Looking for that Nolan Ryan or CC. Still have yet to pull one. I say it every time, and every time it seems like they deny us. Although we have gotten a lot of good pulls this year. Definitely not going to complain. Just have yet to get one of these highlight diamond or gold players that have been in these packs. Once again, nothing in that one. Only two chances left to get CC or Nolan. Can we do it? Not looking good. A bunch of commons and bronzes. Hopefully they sell for a little bit, but I doubt it. Usually they don't. Final pack, what is it going to be? And another huge dud. So I think we got, what, two silvers, one from the topper and one from actual packs. So those packs were not very good for me. Let me know if you guys open any up and what you get. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you later.